Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala Sayyidil Anbiya'i wal Mursaleen. Wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Fa'audhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. يا بني آدم لا يفتننكم الشيطان كما أخرج أبويكم من الجنة ينزع عنهما لباسهما ليريهما سوآتهما إنه يراكم هو وقبيله من حيث لا ترونهم إنا جعلنا الشياطين أولياء للذين لا يؤمنون صدق الله العظيم بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم Dear brothers and sisters, it happened with a feeling of envy, with a feeling of hasad, with a feeling of jealousy, arrogance, superiority. And it happened when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intended to create Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. He created him and then he ordered malaika to do sajda to him. Fasajada al-malaika. All the malaika, all the angels bowed down to Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam except one person. He did not comply to the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it was Iblis, illa Iblis, aba wastakbara wa kana min al-kafirin. He denied, he was proud, and he became among the disbelievers. Since then, till today, and till the day of judgment, there has been an enmity between Shaitan and Insan. It will continue. And it has been reminded, it has been mentioned in Quran several places. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has warned us against this bitter enemy. But unfortunately, in one way or the other, we are entrapped by his tricks, by his traps, by his plans. And we are derailed from the right path. Shaitan said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he saw Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, قَالَ أَرَأَيْتَكَ هَذَا الَّذِي كَرَّمْتَ عَلَيَّ. Iblis said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do you see this one whom you have honored above me? خَلَقْتَنِي مِن نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِن طِينٍ. You created me from fire and you created him out of clay. And the nature of fire is to go up high in the sky, while the dust is humble, it's grounded, the clay. This is the nature of human being. So he said, I'm superior to him. How can I prostrate to him? How can I bow down to him? I cannot. قَالَ فَخْرُجْ مِنْهَا فَإِنَّكَ رَجِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if you don't obey, then leave the place right now. You are the rejected one. And then, out of enmity, out of jealousy, he swore to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I will continue misleading these people, except those who follow your commands. And he started in the paradise itself, trying to mislead our parents, Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, and our mother, Sayyidina Hawa alayhi salatu wasalam. وَقَاسَمَهُمَا إِنِّي لَكُمَا لَمِنَ النَّاصِحِينَ. When were they walking in the gardens of paradise, he came to them and he said, I swear to Allah that I am a sincere advisor to you. Whatever I say, follow it. And you will be those people who will be everlasting here, who will be living here forever. Eat from this fruit. They said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has stopped us not to do it. Then he played his first trick. He said that he stopped you from eating from this so that you should not be everlasting, should not be living here forever. That's why. He played his first trick and he was successful. Some ulama said that Shaitan was kicked out of paradise because of his jealousy, because of his pride. And Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam and Sayyidatuna Hawa alayhi salatu wasalam were expelled from paradise out of their desire to stay there forever. So the desire will lead us to a place where we will not find any mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what happening. We are entrapped in the tricks of Shaitan, with the plans of Shaitan. While Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us, has warned us at several places, saying, أَلَمْ عَاهَدْ إِلَيْكُمْ يَا بَنِي آدَمَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُ الشَّيْطَانِ إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌّ مُبِينٌ. Didn't I remind you, didn't I enjoin upon you, the children of Adam, أَلَّا تَعْبُدُ الشَّيْطَانِ, that you not do not worship Shaitan, do not follow him. Why? إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌّ مُّبِينٌ. Indeed, he is to you a clear enemy. He will not think good of you. At every single given opportunity, he will try to mislead you, take you away from the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and lead you to his wrath, to his wrath and to his anger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كُتِبَ عَلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ مَنْ تَوَلَّهُ فَأَنَّهُ يُضِلُّهُ وَيَهْدِيهِ إِلَىٰ عَذَابِ السَّعِيرِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says again at another place, it has been decreed for him that whosoever turns unto him, meaning Shaitan, he will misguide him and will lead him to the punishment of the blaze, of the fire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already warned us against the tricks of Shaitan. How many worshippers still are deceived and confused by some of the doubts, attractive temptations from Shaitan that lead them to misguidance and result in them saying things about Allah that are not good things, that are not good things, that they do not know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Still they say because they are deceived by the temptation created by Shaitan in their hearts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again reminds us, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌّ مُّبِينٌ. Do not follow the footsteps of Shaitan. Indeed, he is to you a clear enemy. Shaitan always tries to tell us the things which may look good apparently, which may attract us to themselves, because Shaitan wants us to go there, to do that, so that we can face the thing which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not want us to face. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made two things clear: bad things leading to the ways of Shaitan, good things leading to the ways of Rahman. It's up to us what we choose. And unfortunately, even knowingly, we choose the way of ghadab of Rahman. We are inviting the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing things, even though sometimes we feel that we are doing good things. But unknowingly, we are doing things which may not please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just pleasing to Shaitan. And Shaitan is not pleased really. He is pleased because he has been able to misguide us. We are not doing anything good to him. Rather, we are doing bad things to us. Things which are not in our favor. We are doing this thing. And that is what pleases Shaitan. And what are the ways through which he plays with the people, with insan, with the children of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, his first and greatest enemy? First, he attacks the people of knowledge. You will not believe it. He does that. And even the people of knowledge are trapped by his tricks. How? We see in our normal life that there are some people who are hastily giving their opinions about the things they have little knowledge about, and they claim themselves to be great scholars of the Sharia of Islam. Yet they do not hesitate in issuing the fatwa on things they have not mastered yet. And they see, they say that whatever they are saying is true, and whatever others have said is false, is misleading. They do it. And unfortunately, they are following Shaitan. They are not following Rahman. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about such people said in Quran, هَلْ أُنَبِّئُكُمْ عَلَى مَنْ تَنَزَّلُ الشَّيَاطِينَ تَنَزَّلُوا عَلَى كُلِّ أَفَّاكٍ أَثِيمٍ. Because these people have been trapped by Shaitan. These people have been listed in the list of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala among those who are liars, who are sinful liars. And that's why they are easily entrapped by Shaitan. Allah said, هَلْ أُنَبِّئُكُمْ عَلَى مَنْ تَنَزَّلُ الشَّيْطَانِ Shall I inform you upon whom the devils descend? تَنَزَّلُوا عَلَى كُلِّ أَفَّاكٍ أَثِيمٍ They descend upon every sinful liar. These people have been lying. They are following their whims and desire in issuing things which are not in accordance with the Sharia of Islam. Rather, they are totally against it. And they are being in the lines of those among the Ahl Kitab who hid the reality from their people for just little money. وَإِذَا خَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ لَتُبَيِّنُنَّهُ لِلنَّاسِ وَلَا تَكْتُمُونَ فَنَبَذُوهُ وَرَاءَ ظُهُورِهِمْ وَاشْتَرَوْا بِهِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا فَبِئْسَ مَا يَشْتَرُونَ When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the people of Ahl Kitab that make it clear, explain it to the people. Whatever is in your books, tell to the people. Do not hide it. وَلَا تَكْتُمُونَ فَنَبَذُوهُ وَرَاءَ ظُهُورِهِمْ They put this thing, they throw it behind their backs. They throw this command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They threw this promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, threw it behind their back. وَرَاءَ ظُهُورِهِمْ وَاشْتَرَوْا بِهِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا And bought with it ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا A small benefit for a low price. They sold it. They made a deal with it. Okay? Somebody is coming to me asking a fatwa. What do you say, Shaykh, about it? And please, I know that what Sharia says, but please, if you give me according to my desire, I'll give you this thing as a hadiah, as a gift. Accept it from my side. As a $10,000, you know, envelope. I'm doing things which I know that this is against the Sharia of Islam. The Sharia, the Quran, the Hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam do not speak the truth about it. They are against it. And I'm doing things which are not allowed in Islam. And I'm issuing the fatwa, being the Imam of the Masjid, having the authority to issue a fatwa. I'm doing it just for the sake of some money. فَوَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ Announce unto them a painful torment among them. Shaitan plays this trick with these kind of people. He makes desirable and pleasing for the people of different sects the discrimination and degradation of others. Sometimes, if I follow some certain sect, I would always say bad things about others who follow different sects, who follow different madhab. That they are not good, I am the best person. Whatever I follow is always 100% right, and whatever they follow is not right. And I will speak bad about the imams, about the people of other sects, counting them as among the people misled. But unfortunately, I am putting a kind of reward for them, and I am earning a kind of sin for myself by backbiting them, by saying bad things about them, because I know, because I'm doing good and they are not doing good. Whatever my imam says, it's 100% right, and whatever they say is 100% wrong. I'm entrapped by Shaitan in backbiting, in slandering, in attacking people, in accusing them. This is one of the tricks of Shaitan, which he plays with those people of knowledge. And that's what's happening. And in the process, what happened? إِنَّهُمُ اتَّخَذُوا الشَّيَاطِينَ أَوْلِيَاءَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ وَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ What they have done? Indeed, they have taken devils as their allies instead of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, while they thought that they are guided. They think they are guided. وَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. They say that we are the best people, we are on the right path, and everyone else is in the wrong path. This is their condition. And Shaitan has played its plan, his plans and his tricks, and they worked. Second plan, second trick, second trap which Shaitan spreads in the way of Bani Adam is fear of poverty. Fear of poverty, miserliness. These are the weapons of Shaitan. Kufr, poverty is something. Sometime it takes us and makes us closer to kufr, to shirk. It's not a good thing. And that's what Shaitan knows about our nature. He knows about the nature of humans, and he plays with it. الشيطان يعيدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء والله يعيدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا والله واسع عليم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has warned us. He said that Shaitan threatens you with poverty, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ويأمركم بالفحشاء, and based on poverty that you are poor, you do not have anything to eat, do this thing. This is the easiest way. Go buy a ticket, of lottery ticket. You never know, you might win hundreds of thousands of dollars. In one day you become rich. At least take a chance. Go ahead, there's no harm in spending $10 bill. You might get hundreds of thousands of dollars. يَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ وَاللَّهُ يَعِدُكُمْ مَغْفِرَةً مِّنْهُ وَفَضْلًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises you forgiveness from him and bounty. If you follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not only forgive you of all the sins, of all the little mistakes you might have committed in your life, but also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you with his bounties. Wallahu wasi'un alim. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah is an all-encompassing, and he is all-knowing. He knows everything, and he has power over everything. Follow him. You will be forgiven, and you will be blessed with a lot of bounties you may not even imagine in your life. But unfortunately, our iman has been decreasing with due course of time. We have started inclining towards the traps of Shaitan instead of the promises of our Rahman, who promises us to forgive us. We are not going that way. It's reported that some of the prophets asked Iblis, by what did you defeat the son of Adam? And what was the reply of Shaitan? He said, at the time of anger and at the time of desire. In anger, you lose your temper. You do things which you may not do when you are in your full sense. At the time of anger, insan becomes half insane, loses his insane. And at the time of desire, when the desire overcomes you, to be powerful, to be rich, to be somebody, to have everything in life, to have the love of your life, you can go any extent and do things according to the way of Shaitan, not according to the ways of Rahman. As Shaitan knows it, that insan runs behind his desires all the time. So play with it and trap him with it. He does it, and most of the time he is successful. يَعِدُهُمْ وَيُمَنِّيهِمْ وَمَا يَعِدُهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. Shaitan promises them and arouses desire in them, but Shaitan does not promise them except delusions, falsehood. It's not reality. You may not get it. Shaitan always puts good things in your heart so that you can go to that thing. But this is an illusion. This is not reality. Reality is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said. And what happens as a result? When you makes you stand where you can feel a kind of danger, when you are in trouble, then he leaves you behind. he is no more your friend. He is gone. He puts you in trouble, he entrapped you, and his purpose is served. فَلَمَّا تَرَاءَتِ الْفِئَتَانِ نَكَسَ عَلَىٰ عَقِبَيْهِ وَقَالَ إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِّنْكُمْ إِنِّي أَرَىٰ مَا لَا تَرَوْنَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. He said it. What he said? But when the two armies sighted each other, they stand facing each other, and he turned on his heels, meaning Shaitan, and said, indeed, إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِّنْكُمْ, I am disassociated with you. إِنِّي أَرَىٰ مَا لَا تَرَوْنَ, I see what you do not see. إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ, he says, إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ, I fear Allah. He knows it. And when on the day of resurrection, when insan, jinnat, shayateen, everyone will be standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and when the insan will start blaming shaitan, oh Allah, he asked us to do it, we did it because he asked us to do it, what will he say? He will say that وَقَالَ الشَّيْطَانُ لَمَّا قُضِيَ الْأَمْرُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَعَدَكُمْ وَعَدَ الْحَقِّ وَوَعَدْتُكُمْ فَأَخْلَفْتُكُمْ وَمَا كَانَ لِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ إِلَّا أَنْ دَعَوْتُكُمْ فَاسْتَجَبْتُمْ لِي فَلَا تَلُومُونِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ مَا أَنَا بِمُصْرِخِكُمْ وَمَا أَنْتُمْ بِمُصْرِخِي إِنِّي كَفَرْتُ بِمَا أَشْرَكْتُمُونِي مِنْ قَبْلُ إِنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. That I promised you something in that daily life. I do not have any authority over you except that I promised you something and you accepted my promise. You accepted my invitation. So فَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ فَلَا تَلُومُونِي. Do not blame me. وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. He said, إِنِّي كَفَرْتُ بِمَا أَشْرَكْتُمُونِي مِنْ قَبْلُ إِنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. I denied whatever you associate me with. I deny it now. I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is gone. That's another matter what will happen to him on the day of resurrection. But he will be out of your sight. He will put every blame. You might have committed any crime in this worldly life just because of him. He'll put all the blames on you. He is not your friend. He is your biggest enemy. إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌّ مُبِينٌ. Indeed, he is to you a clear enemy, my dear brothers and sisters. This is important thing. We have to understand what is good, what is bad. We go outside, we talk little bit behind the backs of others. Shaitan always puts some ideas in our mind, and we know it, that it is Shaitan who is doing it. Sometimes people come and they say that, Imam Sahab, that Shaitan distracts me in my salah. Shaitan puts this kind of notions and ideas and plannings in my opinion, in my brain, in my mind. What should I do? I know this is Shaitan, but still he does it. He does what Shaitan has put already in his mind. He goes according to his plans. He knows it, and knowingly he is being entrapped. And that's what here we have to understand, my dear brothers and sisters. Those people who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are not entrapped. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا إِذَا مَسَّهُمْ طَائِفٌ مِّنَ الشَّيْطَانِ تَذَكَّرُوا فَإِذَا هُمْ مُبْصِرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran, indeed those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when an impulse touches them from shaitan, they remember suddenly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and at once they have the insight. They know what is right, what is wrong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at another place says, وَإِمَّا يَنْزَغَنَّكَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ نَزْغٌ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. O insan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when anything comes to you from shaitan, any kind of idea, any kind of suggestion come to you from shaitan, فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ, seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. If you seek refuge, if you ask his help, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not far, he is close to you. إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Indeed, he is all hearing and all knowing. My dear brothers and sisters, Everything is clear to us. Everything has been made clear to us in Quran and in the hadith and ways of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now it's upon us whether we choose the ways of Shaitan or choose the ways of Rahman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from the traps of Shaitan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to follow the ways of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and make us closer to Rahman. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. We have